Hey guys, welcome to Laratips. In today's video, we'll be looking at how we can connect to multiple databases in a single project. So in this video, I'll be showing you the list of users, and here I'll show you a button, and by clicking on that button, we can switch the database and get the users from a different database. So currently, I have commented out the button and only shown you the users. First of all, I'll show you how to connect to different databases, and then I'll show you how to switch the databases by clicking on a button. And this video was requested by Vidhan Bania. Here you can see the comment. So in response to that comment, I am making this video. And also, if you want me to make some videos on some topic, then you can just let me know in the comment section below. Then I'll be making a video related to that also. So let's start the video. So here is the list of users. So currently I'm in the root route. So here I go here in the web.psv file. So here you can see list of users. Just ignore this DB connection for now. I'll tell you about this in a later point of time. So here I am just getting the users, and if I go here in the .env file, this is the DB connection. I am connecting to this Laravel 8 database, and if I show you here this Laravel 8 database, select all from users, and there are a lot of users. There are 13 users, but I am only showing you the first 5 users. So you can see the first 5 users here, and also here they are the same users, as you can compare their name. Okay, now let's say we want to access the users from another database, and keep in mind guys, they must be in the same server. So here I have also another database name as Laravel Basics, and here also there is a list of users, and there are only 5 users here, and the first user is this one. Now let's say we want to show the list of these users over here. Then how to do that? And also guys, you can do this in another way also. You can send an AJAX request to that server and fetch the data. That would be one way, and another way would be this what I am showing you, by connecting to the database directly from the server. So for that, we have to create a new database connection. So we have to go into config database. This database file is inside config folder, you can see here, and by default the connection is MySQL. And you can see here, this is also the MySQL. So by default, it will connect to the MySQL, and it is taking the required data from here. So from the connection list, there is also MySQL, and it will take its data from here. Now let us just duplicate this and create a new one. So I have already created here other like this. I have just duplicated it, and in the name of all the env variables, I have just added underscore other like this. Now here in the .env file, I have just copied all these and just added underscore other at the end of all these env variables. So here I have just changed the name of the Laravel Basics, and you can see here the DB host is same in both, which means that they are on the same server. And the password and username is also same here, but it can be anything in your case. Basically, they have to be in the same server. So let's say we want to show the users from this. So in case of MySQL, we have to pass the other over here. I have passed here MySQL, but here should be other like this, the connection name. So now I can go here in the web.psv file, and here, let me just remove this user from here, and I'll use a DB facade over here. And I'll also show you how to do it by using a model. So here users will be DB like this. And here I'll say table, and I'll say users like this. And if we do it like this, then the result will be same. So let me just go here and show you the results. So you can see here it is the same thing. Now I'll show you how to switch the database. So here in front of the table, we'll write connection like this. And in the connection, we'll write other. And now if I refresh the page, you can see here the users list have changed. And now if I go here in the database and show you, the list reflects this data. Okay, now let me also show you how we can do this using the model. We have to go in the user model. Let me undo this first. Now let me go inside the user model. And if you go here inside this authenticable or inside this user, and here we have this model, yeah? So now if I search for connection like this, you can see here protected connection. So if you don't define anything, it will by default take the default one. But if I go here in the users model and just override this protected connection to other like this, and if I come here in the browser and refresh the page over here, now you can see here it is taking the data from the other database connection. Again, if I come here and just comment it out and refresh the page, then you can see here it is taking the user's data from the default connection, which is MySQL. Okay, now I'll show you another way of switching the database connection as well. we don't have to write any connections in the model. So here, let me just remove this. And now if I come here in the web.php, here I'll just switch the connection at runtime. So here I'll say config. And if you see here, inside the config database, we have this default key. I have to just change this key at the runtime. Okay, so here we'll say config database.default is equal to. So let's just write MySQL for now. Now if I come here and reload the page, you can see here we are getting this Alexandra, which is coming from this, as you have already seen before, from this Laravel 8, which is the default database connection. But now if I come here in the code and just change this to other, which is the key that we have defined over here. So now if we see here in the browser, then you can see here the users list have changed, which is from this one. So you have seen three ways of changing the database connection: one using the DB facade, one using the model, and the last one using the config. And now I'll show you, as requested by Vidhan Bania, how to switch database connection on the click of a button. Also guys, this depends on your business logic, whether you want to switch the database for one session or for a specific user or for all the users. So it depends upon the use case or the business logic. But here I'll just show you in general how you can just switch the database on the click of a button, and you can implement it by looking at your business requirement. So here we have the list of users. Now let me go here in the code. I'll just remove it from here. And now if I go here in the welcome.blade.php, I'll just uncomment this code. So if I come here and reload, you can see here the current connection is MySQL, and here is the change connection button. And whenever we click on this change connection button, it will change the current connection. And let me show you the code as well. So here I have this change connection ID over here, and whenever we click on this change connection, I'll just call this change DB connection AJAX request, and then I'll pass this data, and then it will change the connection, and then it will reload the page. Now let me show you this change DB connection here in the web.php. It is over here. In the change DB connection, whatever we passed in the request connection, I am adding that to the DB connection. And let us add this for a very long period of time. So let's say now, let's say add years for 100 years. Okay, we are just imagining that whenever user changes the connection, we don't want that connection to be automatically reverted back to the previous one, unless the user again changes the connection. So we are just adding it to the cache. But you can also create another database connection, and there you can put this data, because let's say at one point of time, let's say we did PHP artisan cache clear, then this data will also get cleared. So in that situation, you can create a new connection and store the database or the current database connection in that one, and fetch it from there. Okay, we are adding whatever connection that we have passed from here, MySQL or other, to this. Let's say if nothing is passed, then we are just assuming it to be MySQL. And here also, we have passed the DB connection. If you see here, we have passed this DB connection. And let's say if there is nothing in the DB connection cache, then by default, we'll pass the MySQL. So here, it will be MySQL by default. And if it is MySQL, then we'll change it to other. Otherwise, we'll change it to MySQL. And if there are more database connections, then you can use the lookup table over here also, which is a very good way of refactoring if-else statement. And if you don't know about that, I have shown this in PHP, and I'll be leaving the link of that video just below that like button. It will make the if-else condition much more cleaner. So here, if the current database is MySQL, then it will pass other, and if it is other, then it will pass MySQL, and we'll put that data to the cache. And whenever we use put method, then it will override the previous value in the cache. So after changing the database connection, we are reloading the page, which means that we are visiting this same laratips.test page. And if you see here in the laratips.test, which is the default root page, we are just sending the users. Now let's see it will change the database connection and fetch the data accordingly or not. So here I'll just click on change connection. So it reloaded and the connection changed to other, but the data is the same. The data is not changing. And if I again click on this change connection, then again this connection name changed, but the data is same. So we are able to change the connection name, but the data is not reflecting to that connection. because at the runtime we haven't changed the database connection. So here you can see here in this root route, we are not doing anything. We are just returning the users and it will take the default connection by default. So we have already seen how to change the connection, but now we'll see here where to change the connection. So now let's go to app service provider, which is inside app providers folder. So I have already written the code over here. I just need to uncomment it. So we have already seen we can change the connection name by using this config. Yeah. So here we'll just get the data from the cache and we'll just assign it to the database.default. So whenever we are clicking on that button, the connection will change and add it to the cache, and that we are fetching here. And we have to add it in the app service provider in the boot method, because the boot method is called when everything is registered in our application. So now I have done this. I'll come here and just reload the page. And you can see here it is giving me the data of the MySQL connection, which is coming from this Laravel 8 database from here. And you can see here the data. Now, if I click on change the connection, it is again not changing. So let me go here. Oh, sorry, I forgot to save it. So let me save it. And now if I come here and again refresh the page, you can see here the data has changed and it is coming from the other connection, which is from this Laravel V6 database. And you can see the data over here. And let me show you one more time. Whenever I click on this change connection, the data is coming from MySQL connection. And again, if I click here, it is coming from this other connection. Now, if I come here in the login, and again, if I go to this home page, then also it will persist the data because we have added that data in the cache, and it will take that connection from the cache and just assign to the config database in the app service provider during the runtime. And one thing that you need to know here is that, so let me go here in the web.php. So here you need to validate the connections before assigning it to the cache, because from the client side, a user can pass any data from there. So you always need to validate the data and then only add it to the cache. So that's it for this video, guys. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Bye.